All right, so let's talk about the average retirement account by age, and then we'll look at the median retirement account by age, all right? And this is important because I think a lot of people, they feel a sense of dread if they're below the average or below the median, and they feel a sense of accomplishment if they're above it. And I get it, but I'm just encouraging you, if you're below the median, don't fear, man. There's still lots of opportunity to get where you need to be, because the one thing that we need you to know is how much do you spend? The only thing that matters is how much do you spend? It doesn't matter what other people have. It matters what you spend. All right, so let's dive into this right here. So here's my 45 to 54. I'm 53, so I'm in this age group right here. The average for in 2022 for my age group is $313,000. That's the average, all right? Now, people who are 55 to 64, the average is $537,000. Now, a couple of things to consider. If you don't have over $500,000, are you below average? The answer is yes. Is that necessarily a bad thing? Not necessarily, because remember, the average always skews towards the outlier. So let me give you an example. So you have 99 people, all right, 99 people, they each have $1,000 in the retirement account. Each have $1,000. You times 99 by 1,000, you get $99,000. That's what they have. So you take $99,000 divided by 99 people, and we have an average retirement account of $1,000. Let's add one more person. All right, so now we get 100 people, but instead of having $1,000 as a retirement account, that one more person has $100,000 as a retirement account. All right, so now instead of having $90,000, $99,000 in there, we have $199,000. All right, so we got $199,000 divided by 100 people. So now our average is almost double. That one guy made our average go from 1,000 to almost 2,000, just that one guy. So in this case, the only person who had above the average was the one guy, because that one guy skewed everything towards the outlier. He's such an outlier that he skews everything. And again, Jeff Bezos, if he has $200 million, Josh has $1, our average retirement account balance is $100 billion. I don't have that, not even close. So is that actually a true measure of averages? Not necessarily. And now we're using this on hundreds of thousands of people, so it's going to the averages won't be quite as absurd as Jeff Bezos and me. But still, I just showed you one guy in that 100 person sample size can skew everything drastically. You see what I'm saying? So don't get too caught up in the averages. But still, there you go. So if you are 55 to 64 and you don't have over $500,000, you don't have the average. If you're 45 to 54 and you don't have over 313,000, you are under average. That's not relevant though. Let's just go here. If you're over 65 to 74, you need to have 609,000. I can almost guarantee people over 75 will have less. Let's take a look. Ready? Oh yeah, look at that. People over 75 have much less than people 65 and people 55. Why is that? Because they're spending down their assets. I mean, obviously, and that's what you save them for. If you're 35 to 44, you're way down here. You got 141,000 is the average. Yeah, who cares? Now we're going to look at the median. That's all that matters. All right, the median is what matters here. So let's go into my category here first. And the median for us is 115. All right, so that's a significant difference. The median is a third of the average. The median means 50% of the people have more, 50% of the people have less. That's 115,000. Now, look, if that's still not you, hang tight. Because I'm going to show you something else here. If that's not you, don't freaking get off this video yet and say, oh, I'm a loser, I suck, I'll never be able to retire. Hang tight, because I'm going to show you something else. That's the median. $115,000 is the median retirement account balance if you're in the age of 45 to 54. I will say that does not include brokerage accounts or bank accounts or anything. That's just literally retirement accounts. All right, so let's keep going. So now let's do the 55 to 64 group. And they're at 185. So that's good. You know, if you're 55 to 64, you have a median retirement account balance of bordering on 200,000 schmackaroonies. Nothing wrong with that. Let's take a look at these guys right here. And they are at $200,000. So basically, people over 55 to 74, that 20-year time frame, that cohort of 20 years, has a median retirement account balance of $200,000. I bet these guys are going to be lower too. Yeah, they're just like me. My age group right here, I should say. So if you're 75 or older, you just got a little bit more than my age group. And again, because they're spending it now. What about the youngins? They're way down here. Look, they dropped off significantly here. They went from 69,000 in 2019. There you go, Joe Biden, to 45,000 in 2022. There's Joe Biden for you right there. And Joe Biden is really, if I'm a young guy, man, he is clobbering you guys. Look at that. He is clobbering you guys. That's just sad. That's just sad. You could say Trump clobbered these guys. Look at this. This group of people, I think this is 65 to this 75-year-olds. Yeah, Trump clobbered them, you could say. I mean, and before Trump came on, they had 148. After Trump, they're at 96. But look at Biden. These guys all vote Democrat. These guys generally vote Republican. Interesting. Won't have anything to do with anything. So let's take a look, though, the percent holding. Let's take a look. So 35 to 44-year-old people, how many people actually hold a retirement account? 61%. That means 39% of the people don't even hold a retirement account. So those averages and medians right here, let me show you down here. The median and mean amounts of holdings are for those who have any. So almost a third don't have anything. And that doesn't include, so they're not including zeros in here. If you included zeros, I don't even know what it'd be. I'm sure we could probably calculate it rather quickly. The median and the averages, if you took a third of that population, that cohort, didn't have any retirement account. I mean, just think about it. You have a third of the people with nothing. The only things we're looking at is the averages and the medians for people actually have something. Isn't that crazy? So in that age group, a third roughly don't have any retirement account. How about my age group? Man, my age group, even more, 62%, I mean, no, less, but still about 30, that's more than, that's about 40% of the people, yeah, roughly 40% of the people in the younger age groups, 45 to 54, don't have any retirement accounts. 4 out of 10. That's crazy. Here, 57%. So 43% of the 55 to 64 don't have a retirement account. These guys right here. Look at that. It's right here. 49% of those 65 to 74 don't have a retirement account. Look at this right here. 42%. 58% of those over 75 have no retirement account. So we're looking at 42% of the population for those 75. Let's do that. 75 and older even have a retirement account. And of that retirement account, the median balance is only $130,000. So over half don't even have one. And the less than half that do have one, the median balance is 130. Well, let's look at this again. So here, about half don't have a retirement account. The ones that do, the median balance is 200. That's pretty interesting. Anyway, so I want to get all caught up on this because I said, no, man, at the end of the day, it's all about your spending. And if you can afford, and just remember, the average, I'm just going to use the average Social Security is $1,900 a month. It doesn't mean what you're going to get. You'll probably get more than that, frankly, probably a lot more. But still, if you use the average Social Security benefit, and if you're married, you can even just even say between my wife and me, we're going to get $2,700 of an average Social Security benefit. I wouldn't do that. I'd get more specific and look at exactly what your Social Security benefit is projected to be, as opposed to just using a number that is average. It has nothing to do with you. And again, we just talked about averages. So the average Social Security benefit doesn't get skewed in that regard. It doesn't. Not the same way we're talking here with Jeff Bezos versus me. But still, at the end of the day, the average in Social Security is not relevant at all to you. What's relevant to you is your specific Social Security benefit, your specific spending. That's the only thing that matters to you. So don't get caught up in this, you know, competing with the Joneses stuff. It doesn't matter. But you do need to know what your Social Security benefit is going to be. And secondly, you need to know that the benefit that you get today is not the benefit you're going to see in the future. Whatever you get in the future will be more, drastically more than the benefit you get today. All right. And the closer you get to your 67 years old, to your full retirement age, the more legitimate the Social Security statement is. All right. The more true the statement will be. But if you're like 50, 45, 40, the statement is way off. What you see is going to be significantly, what you see in your statement today will be significantly lower than your actual benefit when you factor in cost of living adjustments and average wage increases. Anyway, love your thoughts on this. God bless. And don't forget to comment down the doobie doo. And of course, my course, Everything you need to know about investing is still down there. $200. Sign up for it. And if you don't like it after 30 days, you get your money back. There's no risk to you at all. God bless. We'll see you.